Another historic day for the City Football Academy is fast approaching as the stadium prepares to host its first international fixture. England women will take on China here on Thursday the 9th of April, and I've been catching up with one of our England internationals, Karen Bardsley, who's been telling me how excited she is to be playing for her country on home turf.
Oh, it's going to be amazing. I can't wait to play on this pitch. We play here week in, week out. We've already had a few games under our belt here, and they've all been good experiences as well. So I think it's going to be, an amazing atmosphere here if we can sell the place out, which I'm sure we will. I'm really looking forward to just kind of being on our own home turf and not only trying to grow the game in the Northwest, but just trying to put on a good display for a send-off to the World Cup.
And I know it is a friendly, but obviously you want to win. And do you think it's an advantage that you are here in Manchester?
Although it is a friendly, we want to get as much out of the game as we possibly can. So we want as much match prep and tactical prep as we can before we go into the World Cup. So we're going to, you never know who you're going to face in a World Cup, hopefully deep into the tournament. So you want to face as many different type of opponents as you can.
Well, Karen, I imagine the mood in the England camp is quite good, obviously, after the Cyprus Cup win. Just tell us about that whole experience.
It was a really good opportunity for lots of players to get lots of tournament experience. So I think overall, not only did we win the tournament, but we took a lot of other massive positives from it. I think we became close as a group, and it was a really, really good trip for us. And I had the honor of captaining England against the Dutch when we were over there, and that was a massive experience for me and a great honor. So lots of different highlights, and the fact that we brought home the trophy is just one of many, many highlights and one of many positive things I can take away from the tournament.
And as you say, a great way to be preparing for this summer's World Cup in Canada, which I'm sure you are all very excited about.
For a while it seemed like it was so far away that it just felt like it was never going to get here. And then all of a sudden we're like, wow, it's practically here. And, everyone's really excited, but I can imagine that there's some, it's almost squeaky bum time, as they say, So there's going to be a lot of really happy people, and unfortunately there's going to be some disappointed people as well. But, that's just the reality of the situation, but everyone is just so ecstatic for it. I don't think we can't wait till it gets here. I think, every time that we come to the Northwest, we seem to get a really great crowd and a really great buzz and atmosphere at the games. So it would be massive to kind of obviously keep that going into the World Cup. And, we've obviously shown that we can bring a lot of interest because, we've had massive crowds at Wembley, and to make sure that people want to come back to these games, So not only can we put on a show on the pitch, but overall, the day is kind of an event and an occasion for people to kind of look forward to, the next one. With clubs like Man City and the investments that they've made into women's football, it's only going to get better. There's no way it can not get better,
One of our players who will unfortunately be watching her teammates from the stand is Steph Houghton. She's been catching up with Kelly over at the Academy building, along with new signing, Natasha Harding.
Well, Steph, it's great to see you. We've been missing you in the team.
Yeah, obviously disappointing not to be playing, and but injuries are part and parcel of football, and just can't wait to get back.
How is the injury coming along?
Yeah, it's coming along nicely, I think. Taking it day by day, and it's progressing really well, and hoping to be back outside running in the next week or so looking positive.
I know it's always frustrating for players, isn't it, when they're injured, but I guess it's even worse for the captain because you want to be out there leading from the front.
Yeah, of course, I think that's something that I do miss, and by leading by example, but I think I've tried to be part of the team as much as I possibly can and lead back in different ways, and whether that's having conversations before the girls go out, or maybe at half time, just to say from a point of view from the stands, it's important to be part of the teams, and credit to the girls have asked how my injury is every single day, and we just want to win as many games as we can.
A couple of games in, what do you think of how the team's coming together?
I think it was an important win against Doncaster FA Cup. It's a special tournament, and we want to be part of that, and to go to Birmingham away and poor conditions weather-wise, we'll take a point, and hopefully that'll be a very good point at the end of the season. A learning curve for everyone involved, but this year it's all about producing really good performances, and we've got a squad now that's got the ability to win any football game. It's just about how we play on the day, and we've got good quality players to the club, and the ones that were here last season have worked really hard over the winter to get themselves in the best shape that they can do.
So hopefully we're going to see you back soon.
Yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed.
I've been warned that I might need subtitles going into this interview by Steph.
Yeah, just a little bit. I think I get it every day, warmed up by the girls. They never understand me, or I can say the nick out of, but yeah, I'll talk a lot slower today.
So how are you settling in?
Yeah, no, I'm finding it good. The girls have been really welcoming, but I was speaking to the staff and they said they feel like I've been here for years, not 3 weeks. So no, that's always a good sign, I think. So just excited to actually get going on and start playing regularly.
So you sat with KB and Lisa, I think it was, at lunch, making friends?
Yeah, well, trying to. Demi Stokes always says that I'm under like an interview process to become a football friend. So I think I cooked her food once, and I'm making her laugh a little, I think, so I've been so far. So we got a good squad and a good team, and you know, I always want to start, that's why I'm here, and it doesn't bother me if, you know, we are teammates, but we all want to be starting, and I think that's good to have competitiveness, you know, in and among the squad. And yeah, it was good to get 20 minutes under my belt. I wouldn't say, you know, I played 20 minutes, it was more like 20 minutes on the pitch. And the people that know me, I thrive under pressure, and you know, I like that, and I like to challenge myself. And yeah, I think I've given myself a bigger target this year of goals and assists. So me and Marnie, I think I've got a little wager going on to see who gets closest.
We're all really looking forward to the first home league game as well. Arsenal probably doesn't get much bigger than that, does it?
No, we're excited to play them. They've got some great signings, and the Spanish girls, you know, I've played alongside Natalia for 2 years, and she's a great girl and a great signing. Same as, you know, Vicky Lozada, Barcelona player, Spanish international, she's an incredible player. Gemma Rose at the back, young defender, but you know, still strong and competitive, and you know, it'll be a good game, and hopefully a good advert for women's football, but hopefully we'll win.
Yes, it's in.
Remember, you can be part of the women's campaign as season cards are now available. Tickets for the England friendly are also on sale, and details of both can be found on our website at mcfc.co.uk. That's all from us for now. We'll be back next week. See you then.